Okay, good morning to everybody. My name is Mariano Peluso. I am a co-founder and partner of Coffee BI. Coffee BI is an independent research institute specialized in the coffee industry. We support coffee companies with data, information, and analysis. Today we talk about espresso in Italy. Let me do a little introduction. Maybe you know if you traveled to Italy. There is an incredible diversity about north and south. Each region has wine, food, and other characteristics, and this comes out from the history. This is translated also in coffee blend, because if Brazilian Arabicas are appreciated everywhere in Italy, in particular in northeastern part, in northwest there are more aromatic and acid tone. In the south, instead, there is more character of robusta. Another characteristic of Italy is that there are a lot of coffee roasters. Maybe someone counted the 1,000 coffee roasters. So, about coffee roaster, if you see this breakdown, there are not much diversity among the various areas. So there are more or less similar about population and the number of roasters. But we cannot consider Italy as a single coffee country, but we have to broken in 4, 5, or 3 areas, because people drink different coffee. Here, in another map, you can see roughly 50 Italian brands. They are most famous, but I missed also someone. And you imagine that these are only less than 10% of Italian coffee roasters, even if they are the most important brand. You can see Illy in the northeast part, Lavazza northwest, Segafredo northeast center, and Kimbo in the south. So they are the main coffee roaster, but there are also many others. So this is after this introduction. Now there is the summary of my presentation. Before we will start with the dimension of the Italian coffee market, so we understand how is big this market. After, we will see the difference in regional areas. We will analyze each areas. And then we try to understand why there are these differences, why the coffee is so different from northeast to the south. There is an historical region. So let's start with the dimension of the Italian coffee market. We start with the import of green coffee. Italy is the second largest importer of green coffee in terms of volume, after Germany. Germany is the first country in Europe. These are the type of coffee that are imported. Brazilian natural 35%, Robusta 40%, and other mills 20%. In other mills there are more Canefora Robusta inside. So you, from this picture, you can see that Italy mostly is Robustas, a Robusta country. These are imports of they are the country from where arrive coffee. Brazil is the 33%, Vietnam, India, Indonesia. So this is just statistical to understand that which are the main country of import. Another characteristic slide that I would like to show you, it's the main Italian coffee ports. Genoa is the first, Savona that is close to Genoa, so in Liguria there are the mostly, arrive mostly of the coffee. Trieste, around 20%, and Naples, 10%. Remember this data of Naples that we'll see that in the history, it was not in this dimension, but was much more. The coffee market, the volume 253,000 tons. It's more or less the second or third in Europe for volume. The first is Germany. After France and Italy, some year Italy depends on the consumption. In terms of value and volume, in 2019 it's decreasing. Per capita consumption is 4.8. It's not much. Germany is at 6.2. But this is a reason that Italian drink more smaller coffee. In this map you can see also the dimension of the Italian coffee market. Home segment represents 62%, Horeca 20%. Italy has the largest Horeca coffee market in Europe. Office and community, the remaining 16%. So this map represents 100% of the coffee consumed in Italy, in tons, so in volume. Characteristic of the type of Italian coffee market, Volbin 41%, ground 40%. The ground coffee is consumed particularly at home. Volbin is consumed out of home. So there are these two big categories, portioned and instant, that is a very small category in the Italian market. If we enter in detail about the home market, you can see that the coffee consumption in modern distribution. This map represented a part of the home consumption just in modern distribution. You can see the modern distribution and discount represent 43%. Retail online represent 20%. So 43 plus 20%, 60, more or less 63%. Is the whole home consumption in Italy. And you can see from this map that there are no much difference from the main Italian macro region. So the consumption is more or less the similar. When we talk about the coffee in Italy, in general, someone refers to Milan, Trieste, but they represent only half of the Italian consumption. The other half is in the center south of Italy, so there are not much difference. Food service, so the out-of-home, the number of out-of-home. Here in this figure, you can see the number of the Italian bar and coffee shop. They are very huge amount. It's the first in Europe for this. There are bars everywhere in Italy. Restaurant is the second after France. France is the first country in Europe, but also Italy have a lot of restaurants. So coffee out of home is served in bar, coffee shop, restaurant. So you can see that there are you can find the coffee everywhere in Italy. And if you see this graph, this figure, you don't find a lot of difference also in number of bars. So the coffee is not concentrated in the north, not concentrated in the northeast, but there are no much difference if you analyze Italy. So after we will see that this is important for the difference of tests, because we cannot refer to the tests of the coffee in Milan or in Trieste or in Turin, because the other part of Italy drink other kind of coffee. So, after this overview about the dimension, we understood that Italy is the second market for importance in Europe, the first for Horeca. Now let's see the difference in the regional area. That is the main point of my presentation. So the first thing that I would like to show you is different in the price of coffee and cappuccino. In North, the coffee is cost much more, but this is not a characteristic of Italy. It's a characteristic of every country. So in Germany, there are some differences. Italians spend not much, €2-3 for the breakfast. Even if some statistics show that in the South, maybe they spend more than this, probably because they love to eat some pastry that is more that is more expensive. For coffee beverage drinks, più croissant represent 32% of bar income. So bar incomes arrive, most of the bar incomes arrive from other food. Another characteristic is the dimension of cappuccino. I took just the data of the Italian National Espresso Institute, so 160 milliliter, 25 milliliter espresso, and 100 milliliter. So it's a short cappuccino compared to, for example, for a cappuccino drink in Germany. So let's enter in the difference. So coffee in Northeast. In this map, you can see the main brand that are located here, Illy and Segafredo. This area, that is a statistical area, mostly don't represent also the really exactly the test, because if we go in Northeast, Illy, we found the characteristic of light roaster, fruity, spicy aromas. If we go in Emilia-Romagna, in Segafredo area, or Rimini, Bologna, we can find more contamination with the Robusta. So Venice is considered the mother of Italian coffee because the first coffee houses in Italy arrived in Venice. Trieste considered the capital of Italian coffee because it's probably one of the most famous brand. For this area, we see light roasted coffee, modestly bitter, with chocolate vanilla parfum. So it's modest acidity and fruity and spicy aromas. This is the typical coffee preferred in this area. Northwest area. Also, Northwest area is a big area in which include Turin, Piedmont, and Milan. And so if in Turin the coffee is characterized by a marked acidity and fruit traces, there is a bitter taste and shapely body. In Milan, that is a more international town, there are a lot of tourists, a lot of workers coming from other part of Italy. It's influenced both from East and Western characteristics, and recently also from the South. It's not rare to find some coffee specialized in Napolitan coffee, so very dark coffee, also because it's an international town. Anyway, in Milan, typical coffee is long, delicate, and light for a light lunch. So it's other characteristic that there are many sale of coffee-based drinks, cappuccino, marocchino e latte macchiato. Marocchino is typical in Milan area, in northern area. It's a small cappuccino with chocolate. So you can see from this that cappuccino, the dimension of cappuccino is smaller than in Germany. Marocchino is smaller and smaller. So it's it's just a little bit milk. Coffee in center, in the center area. The center area don't have a typical coffee culture, but it's most influenced from north and from the south. Florence probably is most influenced from northern coffee. Rome instead is mostly influenced from Neapolitan coffee. So strong body, quite bitter taste. Coffee should have a brown cream. Romans drink coffee in a glass, in a small glass, with and they and they prefer coffee with a cream. They evaluate the cream with a spoon test. They put the sugar on the spoon, the sugar on the cream, and the more slowly it goes, better is the coffee. This is not a characteristic of only Romans, but also in the South or in other part of Italy, this is not true that the coffee is good or not, but it's typical to understand if coffee is good. So, in the center, there is not a really independent coffee culture, but it's most influenced from northeast, northwest, and the south. The south. So, arrived to the South Island. I included also island because they have not also an independent coffee culture. Maybe Sardinia is most influenced from northwestern part, and Sicily from the south. Anyway, the center of this is Naples. Neapolitan coffee is intense, dark, aromatic, bitter taste, and brown cream, with high percentage of Robusta. In Naples, so Neapolitan Espresso could be considered also the symbol of the ambassador of Italian Espresso. If you have in your mind the Italian Espresso, you imagine shortly dark, and this is the coffee that is served in Naples, but in particular in all southern of Italy. Also, the number of coffee consumed at the bar is double. There are some statistics that show that if in Italy there are 175 cups on average per bar per day, in Naples more than 350 cups. Naturally, the cups are very short. The coffee inside is very short. If you ask a normal coffee in Naples in South, you receive a ristretto. If you want a normal coffee, you have to say long coffee. You have to ask a long coffee to receive a normal Italian coffee that is that anyway is shorter. A glass of water is always free in the South of Italy. And also another characteristic that I can tell you is also the two kind of macchiato that you can ask in Naples. Macchiato, there is a coffee with adding the milk and cream. Macchiato and sfumato. Sfumato is you can only you receive only a cream, a little spoon with the cream on. So it's there are a characteristic of if you ask a coffee in Naples or in the South, you can ask these two kind of drink. Why are these differences? No. After we saw this. This difference in Italy, we ask why, if the coffee historically entered in Venice, starting in Venice, and in the street from Venice to Naples, in the South area, why the taste changed so much? We have to come back to the history to understand the characteristic of the Italian the state before the Italian unification. Here you can see the map of the state, and on the left now the statistical map. That statistical, it's quite similar. So you can understand that the difference that I told you in the introduction about the food, about the culture, about the language come from this, because this single state were separate for a long time, for 1,000 or many hundred years. So, let's see the story. The coffee entered in Naples in 18th century, late in 18th century, because entered before in Venice, after, so in Naples entered very late, at the end of 18th century, thanks to the Queen, Maria Carolina, that was the sister of Maria Antonietta of France, Maria Antoinette introduced the coffee in France, Maria Carolina in Naples. But there were a problem. Neapolitans were great consumers of chocolate. So the local roasters tried to mix a little Robusta and to cook the blend at the right point to give the dark color, because it was used for in the drink of Neapolitans. This is the first problem. The second problem was that that at the beginning the black drink was not seen with the favor by the church, and the King of Naples were very linked to the church and from the superstition. So only after many years, so at the end of 18th century, thanks to a big gastronom and another man expert in superstition, with their paper, they tried to show that not only to drink coffee was health, but was also for good luck. And Neapolitans start to drink, to accept this drink. Another important rule was about the coffee street vendor, because there were not the coffee machine. So the coffee was drinked only in the royal family. Thanks to the coffee street vendor, mostly the population started to understand, to try the coffee, and to understand and appreciate coffee. Then, at the beginning of 19th century, Naples became one of the first Italian ports for import of coffee. This is showed not only from statistics, but also because this machine that is the grandmother of the mocha, that was invented in 1933 in Turin, so many years later. This machine was not invented in Naples, but the name is linked to Naples because at the beginning of 19th century, Naples were one of the first ports in Italy for import of coffee and import also of other invention. This was patented in French, but was adopted in Italy in the house of Neapolitans because after the coffee street vendors and with this machine, many of Neapolitans used this. When I talk, pay attention, when I tell Neapolitans, I'm refer to all South Italian population, because the King of Naples, Neapolitan is like Italians, is a name generic for all the population. This machine is a mix of infusion method and Turkish method. Maybe most of you know this, cucumella. And today it's not used anymore. It's used the mocha, or the mostly it's used the mocha. This difference you can note also in when you go to the bar in Italy. If you the perfect match is coffee and cornetto. The name of cornetto also comes from Austria and the northeast. Kipfer is the legend of Austrian baker for the victory against Turks. And this name also is used croissant in France and Germany, because it means the crescent moon. In Naples, in the south, cornetto. Cornetto is not because not referred to the moon, but for the two horns that is also it's a symbol of lucky, the horn. So coffee and cornetto are for lucky. And if you ask a cornetto in Italy, in Milan, you receive an ice cream. You have to say brioche. So it's cornetto in the center and south of Italy. In Milan, if you go in Milan, you can ask brioche. And cappuccio is a small word about the cappuccino. Cappuccio and brioche in Milan. Finally, this difference that you can see also in the day life, you found also in the bar. In the center and south Italy, there is most used this kind of coffee machine, lever coffee machine. In Naples in particular, now Naples town, not Naples, because it doesn't exist anymore, Naples country, but Naples town, it's rare that you find other type of machine. This is mostly 90-95% of bars have this machine. Why this? Probably because I don't enter in technical characteristic because of the cream that make this machine. Recently, there is also a comeback about many manufacturers to start again this production of this, that is one of the first coffee machine offering new design models, and this, there is a comeback. So these are mostly the difference of Italy. I don't know if you have some question, some curiosity that I can ask. So it's important that if you travel to Milan, don't ask a cornetto, but brioche. Don't ask. But anyway, in Milan, it's international town. There are many workers also other part of Italy. Now you can find bar that serve also dark coffee, Napolitan coffee, and this. Now it's really international town, but all these different come from the history. I don't know if
please feel free to ask questions because
easy question.
We are missing our second speaker, so we have now half an hour to ask questions.
Come back to the map, maybe. This map in which you can see in this map there are I put mostly the famous map, maybe I missed someone. You can see it's if you see the south of Italy, Kimbo is the most famous brand, maybe because also international. Borbone is another Napolitan brand that is the leader in portioned coffee, in capsule. It's the leader in Italy. Other coffee, if you go to Calabria, you can see in the center of Calabria, Guglielmo Cafe is very appreciated by young people. Mauro, Caffè Mauro in Reggio Calabria, in the south. In Puglia, in each part of Puglia, there is a brand, there are three main brands. In Quarta Caffè is from Lecce, it's just the point. Also in Sicily, and also in Sardinia, you can see there. It's and these are just a little amount of the Italian roaster, and each roaster, if in the home market, in supermarket, the market is concentrated. There are Illy, Lavazza, Segafredo, Vegnano, many. There are a few brands in the out of home. In the out of home, it's really very micro. There are micro segments.
Okay, question. We see a lot of brands which are spread over Italy, and some of them are bigger, and they also have an international business. And my question is, the other brands which are located mainly in the south or in the middle, do the coffee like it's preferred in that region, or do they all have the whole taste of Italy? Maybe, for example, Caffè Mauro, do they also produce coffee which is preferred in the north?
No, it's the answer is mixed. There are other brands that in general depends on the area in which they sell. Anyway, Caffè Mauro, for example, it's more dark, more robusta. Anyway, also if you can find, I don't know if you find it supermarket. Anyway, Moak, yes, Moak. I saw also in the north sometimes Moak, but it's more dark. But for example, there is Caffè Vergnano now in this moment. Also, the North brand Caffè Vergnano Lavazza are selling different kind of tests. You can find the Napolitan quality. Also, Caffè Vergnano for sure have a capsule or Napolitan coffee. Also, Lavazza. Also, Hillier starting to put in his offer also different kind. The micro brand that generally not international have one type of coffee, but depends if they want approach to North market, they have to also put the difference. So, so your answer, the answer is a mix of this.
You mentioned the different share of Canefora Robustas from South, Center, yeah, and the North. What is the share, or where does it start in the North, and to which point is it getting?
The point is more or less Emilia-Romagna and Tuscany, more or less, the brand.
Percentage of
Robusta? Depends if we consider the people would like to drink or or the coffee roaster. So you know, you won't know the exact percentage, or no, this is it. Depends on I don't have this information for the moment, because it depends on the of the coffee roaster. That it's anyway, the break is around the Tuscany, in which people start to prefer the dark coffee. But you can also see the dark coffee in Rimini. Rimini also is there are many tourists, and in which it's easy to find coffee that is more dark. People prefer, Italian people prefer this kind of coffee, and brands adapt to the Italian preference. Also, they change completely when they sell in international market, so they adapt to this.
So, but maybe to simplify a little bit, I think in the North, like Italy, they go for 100%
Arabica. Yeah, yes.
Is there also some that are going back for 100% Caneforos? I think like 80% is like the maximum.
I don't think there is 100%, but anyway, Kimbo is very dark. It's very strong. Maybe they use it, but also Kimbo now started to offer 100% Arabic, because it's started to sell, open also a coffee point in Milan, so they started to sell 100% Arabic. So this show that they adapt to the market where they go.
Very different to what we have in Germany or outside of Italy. I always remember going to Belgium. You're sometimes confused if you're already getting filter coffee or if it's still supposed to be espresso just by volume, which is very surprising. But we have the same effect here. If we are trying to convince a German owner of a restaurant or hotel to make a correct espresso, they always put a huge amount of water because they feel the water is what justifies the higher price. I think it's not. It's better to serve a glass of water at the side instead of diluting it completely. Like I think the average size, which you know, the average size of cappuccino in Germany is around like 200 milliliters?
Yes, 200, yes. So this is also the consumption of coffee in Germany per capita is higher than in Italy. It's one of the first European
countries. Well, the big difference wouldn't be that it contains more milk, it contains maybe more water.
No, more water,
you make like Caffè Lungo, Super Lungo.
Yes.
Lungo today is basic, and then we are adding the water.
Yes.
This is now changing a little bit in Germany due to the fact that we have different tax depending on if we have in a beverage above 75% milk or not. So the question is how much is the percentage of milk inside? This is what most people don't know. So this is why now we are getting some better cappuccinos thanks to tax. It's a very nice side effect we're having here, so that even some ready-to-drink coffees you find in supermarkets have now a reduced liquid coffee part in it to be able to sell as a food and not as a beverage. Since you know, coffee, before the COVID tax, had 19% tax with interest. Before we had a 7 on food, but we had 19 on coffee. So no matter if you had an espresso in a place or if you would drink espresso to take away, it would both times be 19%. Now most people were surprised and said, oh, if it's to go, it must be 7. The answer is no, because it was not considered that the main part of producing an espresso would be to put the coffee inside, but to have the service, to have a barista doing it. So it was a German considered Dienstleistung instead of Getränk. And that is important. So if you have 75% minimum content of milk, you can serve it as a food. If you are below 75%, it is actually a service. So that's also with drinking chocolate. It depends if the chocolate is done based upon milk or upon water in Germany. It's a different tax situation. Just that you know, sometimes tax can be good. So tax is helping us in Germany to get a higher quality cappuccino, actually, which would be a nice way for an article. It's like the tapas in Spain also just created by not allowing people to have a vino fino in the day. So they said you can only have it with food. And so what was the food? Do you eat an olive? Is that already food? So the law was the food has to be at least as big to be able to cover the glass that you drink, tapas. So it had to be a tapas. So they would measure that the jamón serrano would at least cover the little cup that you would drink. So you see, sometimes we shouldn't only be just shouting on taxes. Sometimes taxes can help for better food. Okay? Anything else? Any questions?
The specialty roaster now it's the specialty sounding in Italy, because there are many brands are starting to have a brand or a product that is a specialty. Naturally, there is not I don't see, apart some characteristics, the really specialty culture in which you go to a bar to ask that you have a different product. This is very rare in Italy. There are some specialties. So it's more the brand are started, probably the big consumption of capsule or portioned that really put the special product or characteristic of the Nespresso or other brand that give you this difference, maybe help the consumers to understand that there is a difference from coffee to another. But in a coffee shop or bar, it's very rare. There are some bar, there are some coffee shop, but are not. So probably these come from the big brand. Starbucks, the new Starbucks roastery in Milan, started to do this, and the people start to understand that there are some difference in some coffee to another. So it's at the beginning, the specialty. If you want to consider the specialty, also the product that one brand sell, there is Illy specialty, Lavazza specialty product. So but I consider this more specialty sounding, not really specialty. Anyway, the quality of coffee it's improving. Anyway.
Thank you so much for being with us
here. Okay, thank you.
I'm quite sure you will be also still a while in the house, right? So if there's some more questions,
okay, yes, sure.
I might be able to just grab you.
Yeah, no, I see here.
Yes, and also if we have some questions coming maybe also online later we can see if we can collect some questions and maybe get you also into some sort of a chat later so that we can get some questions going also abroad. Okay, so we'll have a short break and then we'll have the next speaker coming up, which is the oversight. Then, yes, Oliver Brudel, then that would be at 12:13, so maybe we start like at 12:15, so like in about 10 minutes, I suppose, or a bit, like, yeah, 6 minutes. So just maybe you slowly get ready, and if you have some questions, so whoever wants to stay, just stay in your place, what's going on, and whoever wants to walk through the house, feel free. There are options.